Our coverage of Computex 2025 from Taipei, Taiwan is brought to you by Cooler Master, G-Skill, Trix, Thermaltake, and Gigabyte.
What's up, guys? I'm just enjoying the flowery scents of the bouquets that they have here at the G-Skill booth. G-Skill, of course, specializes in making memory, high-speed memory for gaming. Also, if you're building like a really nice high-end AI PC, because I know there are people who are into that, not everyone is hating on AI right now. Some really high capacity, high speed, low latency memory kit setups that they have going on right now, which I was quite impressed with, especially with four sticks. But what we're gonna start with is some brand new designs for their memory that I would love to hear your feedback on in the comments section down below. Some of them are quite blingy. We're gonna start with something simple right over here, which is these nice piano white finishes. They're so clean. This is the Trident Z5 Neo X RGB lineup. As you can hopefully see, the one on the right there is gonna support RGB with an RGB strip. And if you're not into RGB, they've also got one with a more clean black top panel as well. Not much to show on the back there. G-Skill is planning on launching these soon because I think for anyone who's building a white system who wants something that has that clean look, these are gonna match perfectly. But they've also got some more unique designs, like these over here. So this is a concept design, which is so shiny and sparkly. I don't know what I want to compare it to. Like Twilight? Ignore that I brought up Twilight at all, but maybe Edward's skin is kind of looking like that. The Royal RGB lineup, you might have seen, has some very shiny silver and gold finishes and has this sort of crystallized look across the top for the RGB, which does have a very unique look if you're building a system that you want to be as shiny as possible. Again, this is a concept design, so they're looking for feedback. If you guys love these, let me know in the comments below. If you guys don't love these, hey, you can let me know too, because G-Skill is going to be reading those comments, and I didn't touch them. I'm not going to touch them. Here are some unique memory sticks from G-Skill, and that is a very bold color, I will say. I remember colors like these from when I was a little kid. I'm not going to tell you how long ago that was, but I had some rollerblades that had they were black with this accent color on it, which is, I don't want to say it's yellow. I think it's green. They also have this very bright and vivid orange here. Again, just some additional trim for the Trident Z5 Neo X RGB kits. And again, guys, let me know what you think of these in the comments. I think if you have a perfectly coordinated system, you could make these really pop and look nice, and definitely a unique color choice versus a lot of the stuff that's on the market. But definitely they would be somewhat limiting in the color scheme for the rest of your case. So let me know what you think of those in the comments. And over here is a system that actually has a kit installed, so you can see just how much that stands out. Like, you used to have RGB to make your memory stand out. Now you can just have it be like a hot orange color. That's super sexy. This system over here is actually running a pretty impressive memory configuration. This is in collaboration with Gigabyte. It's running their AI Top 100 Z890 motherboard, and it is doing AI stuff. It's training a model. It's doing AI stuff up there. But the memory kit running in here is a 128 gig kit that's two 64 gig sticks running at DDR5 7200 with cast latency 38. So that one's giving you a lot of capacity with a speed that is pretty impressive right there. Again, given the capacity of those sticks. Over here we have a dual 24 gig kit running at DDR5 10,747. They had a similar setup last year running at 1200, but it was just with a single stick of memory. Here they're maintaining dual channel memory support, also with pretty impressive timings. CL68, 128, 128. By the way, these systems we're looking at right now are running Intel platforms, so the Ultra 9 285K, but we do have some AMD systems to show you as well. Here's another build that has that blingy orange with some accent lighting on the RGB on the fans, which I think is also blended in pretty nicely. It'd be nice to sync up the RGB on that video card too, but these demo systems are running really fast, high capacity memory configurations. So adding in some RGB control in the background isn't necessarily what they want to do at the moment. Still, we got a DDR5 10,266 speed kit running here at CL46 with two 24 gig sticks. This is the same memory capacity and timings, just running on a different Gigabyte motherboard, Z890 Aorus Tachyon Ice. Here's a 64 gig kit, 2x32 gig CL48, running at DDR5 9000 with an Ultra 9 285K and an MSI Meg Z890 Unify X motherboard. And before we move on to the AMD configurations, I wanted to quickly show this system, which was put together by Elmore of Elmore Labs. The goal was a 1000 FPS setup running Hogwarts Legacy. Here is all the hardware that Elmore used in order to set up this system running at 1000 frames per second. And that is, of course, greatly assisted by the fact that we have a really nice high-speed memory kit running DDR5 6400, which is very suitable for the AMD Ryzen 7 9800X 3D CPU that's installed, and super low latency at CL26, and that is a 64 gig 2x32 gig kit. Now, I couldn't help but need to check something in this little setup, because what resolution is this? Well, it's 2560 by 1440. It's actually running at 853 by 480, or 34% of that resolution, using NVIDIA DLSS to upscale. So that makes sense. And yes, we're also using multi-frame generation. But you know what? In a single-player title, I don't mind multi-frame generation. It is the misrepresentation of multi-frame generation as being exactly the same as natively rendered frames that really irks me. I think as a smoothing technology in a single-player title, it has a place. I just can't really give it credit for that because we only hear about how NVIDIA is misrepresenting this technology. But still, a very impressive demonstration from Elmore. Great job. I have a group following behind me, so I need to go quickly. Here we have some AMD setups. Ryzen 9 9950X3D, DDR5 6000 memory kit, CL26, 248 gig sticks in there. And look, it's even got RGB too. Very nice. Speaking of capacity, oh my gosh, this is a 256 gig setup. That is not two, but four DIMMs. And if you guys have messed around with AMD platforms and trying to go from two sticks to four sticks, it can be super tricky. So the fact that they have a 256 gig kit running here at DDR5 7000, especially with the CL38 timings, I think this is maybe my favorite setup that they have on display here. Here's another demo, slightly less capacity at 128 gigs, but they increased the speed to DDR5 8400 at CL48. And again, this is with a two-stick setup. And then something perhaps a little bit more towards the realm of reality for normal people, DDR5 6000, which is, again, kind of the sweet spot for an AMD Ryzen CPU. Look at that timing though, CL26, and four sticks again, 192 gigs, 48 gigs by four. Here we got DDR5 6400, a 192 gig kit, CL38. Here's DDR5 10600, CL58, and again, a 48 gig setup. But this one is with a Ryzen 5 8500G, a bit more of a challenging CPU to get that configuration running on. All right, so that was a lot of memory in different configurations, and I know you memory nerds out there get impressed at what G-Skill is able to accomplish here, but another thing that G-Skill does at Computex every year is they have their overclocking world stage, which we walked past as we were coming in. Overclockers from around the world are invited to overclock for the entire week, so I'm posting this video towards the beginning of the week. I highly recommend checking out the link to G-Skill's website down in the video description so you can see what world records were broken this week, perhaps new high watermark sets for performance in PC hardware. Apart from the overclocking world stage, they also have a modding setup over here. And I love how G-Skill showcases modders and some of the unique setups that they put together. So let's take a look. This is a PC, as you can see. Memory on display right there up front. I think that is just for show though, because there's more memory installed right there. This is a vending machine. Look at all that.
Wine and soju and the beer.
Wine and soju?
Yeah.
Okay.
So this is, we have both different beverages.
Red wine, soju.
Soju, yeah. Soju.
Oh my gosh.
Coke and beer.
Okay, beer, I guess. Oh, look, even Coke and beer. Yes, please. Oh! Clean up on aisle three. Should I tell G-Skill that this is my first meeting of the morning and cheers. Ooh, that's pretty good. Here's a mod by AK in the Thermaltake CTE E550 TG Snow mid-tower chassis. This one also looks like it has beer inside. That might be a little bit of a theme. Running a Founders Edition RTX 5090. GGF Events has a YouTube channel where they do some really epic mods. They do a great job over there. So this is their build in the Hardline Nexus Valkyrie XL. That's a really cool build right there. I like sort of the open chassis. This is from Noguchi. It's a Enz Factory one-off build, so a custom case, and as you can see, you got a dancing anime. Who is that? It's not Hatsune Miku. I don't know anyone else besides that. Anyway, that's a unique build. Look how shiny it is. This reminds me of like a RoboCop build or something like that, maybe to go along with the mech they had last year. JP Modified made this system, which, like, where's the computer? I don't know. Look, it's got a car in there and sort of like a, looks like an air chamber where maybe it blows LN2 over the card or something. That's pretty cool looking though. T, anyone? Look at this one. This might be my favorite. I don't know. This is from Techlin Mod using a Height Y70 Touch pink case, heavily modified. As you can see, it's built to look like a little tea house with pink accents on the inside. It looks like they've done a lot of custom painting on this system. A little bit of extra accents on the video card as well, just to sort of finish things off. Wow, I love the attention to detail here. And if you look at it from this side, you can tell that yes, it is a full custom water-cooled system as well with Bits Power equipment. Super nice. Moving down the line, this one's from MP Customized using a 3D printed MP Customized design case. Not the first pyramid case that I've seen, but this one definitely keeps the size down a little bit. I really like the shiny white finish on there and the practical usage of a single fan there to keep things cool in terms of the internals. Just no graphics card. I guess maybe that fell out in shipping. This is like a Manta Ray made by Modding Cafe. This is obviously a custom design case, and oh my gosh, look at those mechanics in there. It's rotating, so the fins of the Manta Ray flap up and down in a very slow, gentle, it's like almost like it's swimming through the ocean right there. I also love the exhaust ports right here, letting out a little bit of steam. That gives a really cool effect as well. Man, I'm impressed. I can't tell which one of these is my favorite. I didn't even notice the tail up there. It's even got a tail with some LEDs on the end. Super nice. And here we have a build by WMP. It's using a custom modded case again. This obviously has there's no retail version of a case that looks just like this. It appears to be looking at me. Are you facial tracking me? Are you looking at me right now? You're shaking your head like, no, I'm not watching you. Okay, I like the RGB. Yes, it is a computer. There's a Mini ITX motherboard tucked in there with a really cool looking block. Dang, they really went above and beyond it to feel like the modders at the G-Skill booth this year. But that is all the time that I have here at G-Skill. I want to say a huge thank you to them for sponsoring my content for Computex 2025. Also a thank you to my additional sponsors, Trix, Cooler Master, Thermaltake, and Gigabyte. I have lots more videos coming at you guys real soon, so subscribe if you're not already. Check out the playlist in the video's description if you want to see all of my Computex content, and we'll see you all in the next one. All right.